Well, it turns out that at school, I was actually pretty good at chemistry. I wanted to be a physicist, but because of my background coming from a Middle Eastern country, I couldn't really walk into a nuclear reactor and work on radiation bombs and things like that people do. I really want to become a physicist. And I was very talented in physics. But then I got blocked from doing this because of my circuitous route, going from as an immigrant, as a British student, and then and basically an American student as well. So basically I had no choice but to move into chemistry. But I actually turned out to be a good thing for me because I worked on natural products first and subsequently on nucleosides, which are basically the building blocks for DNA and RNA. And if you think about it, just about every virus on this planet has a DNA or RNA. So I started my career at Emory back in 78. I started working on combination chemotherapy for herpes virus. I was actually one of the biggest proponents of combination chemotherapy. I wrote many papers, published my early papers. The first maybe 5 or 10 papers in my life were all on combination, almost all of them on combination chemotherapy. So I've been a leader in combination chemotherapy. But unfortunately at the time, even for herpes, people didn't believe in combination for viruses. We had already combinations, of course, for TB and for cancer, but nobody believed you really need the combination for viral infections. Back in 1983, I got my first NIH grant on combination chemotherapy, and I think it was probably the very first ever combination grant at NIH for antivirals. And we laid the foundations for what we know today for combination chemotherapy. The background in nucleoside chemistry propelled us to the front of the line, and we were the first to, for example, set up the first HIV lab at Emory University. When at the time we didn't even know too much about HIV, we didn't know if it was a respiratory virus, we didn't know if it could affect us personally, but we worked on it because there was a need and there was an urgency, and we took the gamble to work on HIV, and it paid off. In collaboration with Dr. Dennis Liotta, I was able to work with him for several years in developing antiretroviral agents, and probably one of the most successful antiretroviral agents was FTC, what we call FTC today, enterocytabine, which is a very powerful anti-HIV drug that's used widely among many drug combinations, and the fixed dose combinations for HIV. It is estimated that about 94% of the people with HIV take one of our drugs that was invented at Emory. The other one, of course, was lamivudine, and before that, stavudine. So this led to a whole plethora of compounds because the drug combination became popular, and subsequently we moved on to hepatitis B because we found some of our HIV compounds were also effective against hepatitis B, so we're killing two birds with one stone. I've always been in academia. I've never had a real job in industry. I trained in industry, but I never actually took a job with a salary from industry, ever. But I've also realized very quickly that academia is not a great place to develop drugs once you've discovered them. So you need to translate that. And if nobody is interested in what you have, then I was basically forced, in quotes, to develop my own companies. So that actually led to companies like Idenix, Pharmacet, CoCrystal. These are companies that I've been involved in a founder of. Most of these companies, Triangle Pharmaceutical is another one in North Carolina. We sold these companies except for CoCrystal, and clearly they've been very successful, and every time more and more successful as we learn more how to develop drugs, how to discover drugs. And this is all translation research from the laboratory to the clinic, and that made a big difference. And the speed at which biotech goes forward now, much faster than the big companies like Pfizer, like GSK, all these, they have a lot of knowledge, but we can do it much more effectively, much cheaper, and with a speed that is unknown in drug companies. In drug discovery, which is our major topic, we have to basically develop drugs that not just treat, but also cure. So we're very interested in curative therapy to solve the problem permanently so people don't suffer and have significant morbidity and mortality going forward. Enough of band-aids. I think it's time for us to have cures. A lot of scientists discover many things, but it sits on the shelf. To me, I couldn't tolerate that. So I took the risk to move my compounds, even using my credit card, to be able to form companies like Pharmacet, for example, that became hugely successful and eventually sold for $11.4 billion, with billion with a B, not an M. So it was an amazing story, an amazing success story. We did it from zero to 13 years. The company got sold 13 years after being founded. That's very impressive, pretty fast. We were 6 months away from getting a US NDA, which is the approval, when we sold the company. And there were a lot of bidders, a lot of interest in the technology. Today, the drug is widely used and saves millions of lives. So that's a big, when I wake up in the morning, I'm really happy to have saved so many lives. Not only me, but also my collaborators. I think we all work together on this. The industry, academia, collaborators, we all, advisors, consultants, medical team, everybody was involved in this. And the success is not really measured by the amount of money you make, it's by the lives that you save.